already. So it's about time to start splitting some of this wood. So that's what I'm going to be working on today. So I'm going to start by trying to get all this stuff. I kind of closed myself in over here, so I'm going to start by clearing this so I can walk around the machine. And then also work on this edge of the pile, because I like to be able to pull my trailer right up to the edge of this, but right now I can't. So I'm going to try to make as much of this pile disappear as I can. This is where all the B-grade stuff goes. Maybe I'll move some of that pile today. And then the rest will get stacked in the piles. I guess before I get started, I'm just going to do a little survey of what's here. That way I could see how much I get done today. It's all ash. Okay. All right, so I cleared a nice hole around the splitter and I got a trailer load. So I'm just gonna go stack it in that pile up there. So when I get to the point that half the trailer is clear, I finish piling this side. Rather than throwing all that stuff to this side and continuing to pile here, I'm just gonna drive around to the other side of the pile and start stacking that way. Okie doke. Alright, so I think that's all the splitting and stacking I'm going to do today. This whole center line was here already. But this pile on this side, and then this pile over here, from here over, is what I got done today. And I guess a little explanation on the funny business going on with how we're stacking it. Since we're here in the Catskills of upstate New York, there's really not a whole lot of flat ground here. So to be able to achieve nice, neat looking stacks, which is important for the customer whose property we're stacking this on, I came up with this funny pallet leveling system. We just used some waste construction lumber from a build he's working on right now, up over there, and used that to level out these pallets. And I make sides from them. I gotta do it on the other side still. And so far, it's been working okay. For now, this works. The customer did ask me to do one little chore for him before I go, and he's gonna boil some maple sap tonight. And he's got some splits of oak that were being used as fence posts that he doesn't need anymore. So I'm gonna go retrieve them and cut them down for him quickly. All right, so this is what I'm taking. These are posts of red oak that were split about 2 years ago, I think, two summers ago. They used them as fence posts for this garden fence. I think it's like a Swedish style fence, but they don't need them anymore, so I'm gonna try to cut them up and see if it'll burn for them to boil maple with. Looks like it might. I don't know. Let's see. Alright, so this is where they do their maple sap boiling, so I'm just gonna drop this stuff right there. Here's an echo that I grabbed from my farm that I gotta fix up. I think my saw's a little dull right now. I didn't know I was gonna be cutting today, but should be okay. He told me it was red oak, and those first two pieces I cut are locust, so I'm just gonna call him and make sure I'm taking from the right pile. Okay, I got the green light. think about sawdust, so I guess I better clean this up before I pile it up. You saw the way that kicked back on me. Dry and split stuff has a tendency to do that more than stuff that's round and green. So, be careful. Alright, so this should be enough to boil the sap that's up in the tank. This is probably going to be the last boiling event of the season anyway, so he's got some more wood over there that he could use. It's just nicer, drier hickory, so it's a shame to use it just to boil sap with, but yeah.